My glasses are all bent, AirPods have gone, man's got his foot on my head, everyone's got his foot.
Man treated you like a carpet.
Aladdin fam. Bro, I actually got wrapped. Welcome back to the greatest show on planet fucking Earth.
Do you know what's so sick? I think it's so amazing that you think you're so good looking.
Yeah.
Because you remind me of them parents that bring their kids on X Factor and say that they can sing. Yeah, and they sing and they're shit, yeah.
When it comes to good looks, I'm a pathological liar.
Because,
well, I lie so much telling everyone I'm so good looking, I start to believe in myself.
No, I did at one point until, like, I went to dinner with one lady. I was like, yeah, I'm buff. She goes, no, you're not. And it just hit me, like, you know, like, for example, when they zoom in the face and everything.
Yeah.
I was like, raw, I'm not. Then I saw the mother of my kids. I was like, oh. I put myself in a different category now. I'm the best looking ugly person I know.
Yeah, Jay Huss.
Nah.
Because he's.
I'm better looking than Jay Huss.
Yeah, I think you are.
Yeah, no, yeah. I know I am.
If my girl had to move on to bigger and better things, to better looking guys, I'd support her in that move.
How?
I'd be behind her the whole time.
You're an idiot.
Because she'd leave me behind. I don't expect you to drive a Peugeot for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
You have to say, you know what, one day I'm going to get the Ferrari or...
I reckon I'm a really nice Nissan Micra.
I think I'm an Uber.
A Toyota Prius?
No. I'm
you
about.
You can be anything.
I'm about.
Like Uber like this. I gotta get an Uber tattoo.
Oh, you're done at it, fam. If it was a threesome, that'd be Uber Paul.
I don't know about this guy, Paul.
Nah?
Yeah.
Nah, Paul's done at it, fam. We've got a special guest on today's episode that's not really influencing the music industry or something, fam. Shacking on the beat as well.
I feel like influencing social media.
I shack on the beat as well.
Hey.
People, none other than Madam Shack on the beat as well, Loz.
What?
No, she's not coming.
Amazing.
That's calm. That's fine.
That's
actually not a problem for me.
That is amazing.
Today's guest is not turning up.
That is
that's actually calm.
Sick.
That's so calm. That's actually taking a lot of weight off my shoulders. I'm not bothered.
I'll be honest with you. I'm not bothered. I said to you, what the fuck are we going to talk to this girl about?
So she's not turning up?
No.
Calm. Say nothing. You know how long I've run the Gasworks episode, just you and me?
Serious?
Yeah. Calm, that's actually very calm. That's
Bam.
Very calm.
She turned man down. Man got a Nando's.
Now, a lot of people have fucked us about with Gasworks. Mm-hmm. A lot of people have cancelled, but nobody has ever cancelled on the day. So
that's
I rate that.
That's
she cancelled an hour before she had to be here.
An hour before?
Oh, it seems like it.
Well, big man, we were meant to start at 4 o'clock. I don't know about your thing, my thing is 5 o'clock right now.
Oh, she's cancelled an hour after. That's so very, that's calm.
I'm GMT plus one, so she's on time for me. I live on Sweden time, so right now, we're actually late, actually.
Anyway, man, for time, man, I've been saying, oh, one day you'll get beaten up, yeah? I never thought it would be the Dutch fucking feds, fam.
But what happened last time we went to Amsterdam?
We were leaving. We got rowdy.
We, unless you're speaking French, means both of us.
Yeah.
I don't remember getting rowdy. I remember saying to everybody, is this what he's doing? All right, take care. I'm never really interested in much things. I'm definitely not interested.
Anywhere I was on that holiday, you was, apart from my bed.
I left. I had an earlier flight, remember? And you lot were there. You were arguing with the guy about sitting on the bike. Yeah. I wasn't prepared to argue about something that I don't care about.
But I've listened here.
Craig David, walk away.
Poet's dad, walk away. Here's what it is.
They came back. What hurt more?
What?
Them beating you up or Shaka in the beat saying, I'm not coming.
Bruv, them beating me up, yeah? It didn't even hurt, like it hurt obviously, and it still does hurt, like it still carries on to this day, like there's pains in areas, fam. Listen, I'm bad, innit? I'm actually, but which camera do I look at? Because I'm fucking bad, yeah? I've been jailed before, fam, yeah? As Skepta said,
been to jail on remand in foreign countries, no tell me about crime.
I'm a bad boy now, I'm actually bad.
Yeah,
like who can, have you been locked up?
To me?
No one's been locked up, fam.
I've never been locked up.
I've been jailed, I really do this, bro.
I hear you.
I'm really a fucking about this. Oh yeah, anyway, so I went passport control, but 20 of us must have flown from Heathrow, innit?
20?
No, 20, yeah.
Well, you don't come like so solid, I read that.
Yeah, come on. So there's 20 of us, we've gone to passport control. Everyone's gone through, no problem. You know the e-gates? The one where you slide your thing like an Oyster card. Now, we've got a brethren called Hashem, yeah? He's Somali, he's got big afro hair, he's fucking like 11 foot, he just sticks out. He's put his passport on, but his e-gate hasn't opened, yeah? There was a problem with his, like, sometimes it fucks up.
It happens.
But when it happens, yeah? When the e-gate doesn't open, you just go to passport control, they check your passport and they let you in. Without even looking at his passport, man said to me, your passport's fake.
Who said that?
The border force. Without even looking, bro, he just looked at it, he goes, your passport's fake.
You know Holland has bare racism?
Bro, this is, bro,
did you see? Racism.
So then Hashem's like, what do you mean my passport's fake? Bruv, straight away a man goes, shut up. Yeah? So I'm like, nah. Bruv, I've come to your country, I'm a tourist in, we're not getting spoken to like this, innit? So obviously I've gone to back it now. Then man said to our friend, yeah, Hashem, he goes, come to the back, we're gonna interrogate you. I've never seen racism like this. So I said, bro, you can't, what do you mean interrogate, like, where are you taking him? There's 20 of us, we've all just come here. He's taking him to a back room. We don't know where he's going. We don't know who my man is. Like, we don't know what's going on. Out of safety for Hashem and me and the whole group, I took a photo of the police officer here. Yeah? I said, calm, like, if you're not even going to tell us where you're taking our friend, I'm saying to him, how long will he be gone for? You're saying you're going to interrogate our friend. Like, we can't wait around. There's 20 of us. Like, how long is he going to be gone for? Shut up, shut up. I'll arrest you. Shut up. They've started interrogating him, yeah? Then my man's come back with a colleague, the police officer. He goes, did you take my photo? I said, of course I took your photo, bro. Like, I took it in front of you. He goes, delete the picture, like this. I said, bro, you're a public servant, you work for civilians, it's not illegal to be taking photos of you, innit? He goes, if I ask you to delete my photo, you delete my photo. I said, bro, unless I've broken the law, if you treated us with respect, we probably would have taken a photo of you anyway.
Bruv. This is a serious story, wow.
Bruv, come on.
It's a bit like EastEnders.
Yeah, straight from. So yeah, then my guy goes, delete it, delete it. Then he's like shouting, delete the picture, like this. I said, brother, who's on what? Like this, on my mother's life. Yeah, bruv, I'm not a dickhead, innit? Listen, when I put the video up, everyone was like, oh, he probably got lippy. But fam, I'm not there to be spoken to like a prick, fam. I know my rights, I know what I'm doing, whatever. Everyone started shouting, he said, delete the picture. I said, but who's on what? Like this. Obviously, there was 20 men there, I must have got a bit gassed. Gee, they rapped me. They just rapped me. One of them just sparked me in the face. The other one grabbed my two arms. Bro, didn't even tell me that I was under arrest. Like, just rapped me like that. I was taking beatings, bro. See when they put me in that door? You saw the guy? Yeah. He ran in and just jumped on my neck and just slammed me to the ground.
Hey, nah, come on, man. Nah.
Bro, when I tell you they were kicking my sides in, like kneeing me, kicking, like, bruv, my glasses were all bent, earpods have gone, man's got his foot on my head. Everyone's got his foot.
Man treated you like a carpet.
Aladdin fam. Bro, I actually got wrapped, yeah? And the thing is like,
oh God.
I could have got wound up and I could have like,
bro, you did get wound up.
Yeah, of course I got wound up, but I wasn't trying to fight back basically. Bro, there was 10 man. Like,
they looked strong as fuck.
Bro, they were hench. They battered me. So now, man's thrown me into a cell, yeah? So I'm in a cell now. Yeah, they're taking the cuffs on me. I have to put it on the wall. Man goes, we're gonna have to strip search you. I said, what? I said, why would you have to strip search me? I'm not in here for no drug-related offences. I said, let my lawyer come, let me get interrogated, and then if you need to strip search me, we'll see. Anyway, so they've taken all my belongings, put it in a plastic bag, all this. My glasses are in the other room, I can't see shit. My earpods are here and there. My phone, I don't know where my phone
man
is.
Man, I'm laughing behind the camera, you know? Man can't see it. I'm man's Ray Charles in this thing now.
The thing
it's
is,
mad.
If I got caught lacking by someone else, that's a different story. But this is feds beating the shit out of me. Like, it doesn't make no sense. Then they open my wallet and see my press card. They're like, rah, press. They thought I was some BBC journalist or something. So they started to get a bit shook. When you've been locked up, it's your right to know what offence you've caused. Like, if they've put you in a cell, it's like, bro, I want to know what offence I've committed. No one could tell me. But they kept coming in here. They're like, you can be here for 9 hours. You're probably going to stay overnight. Like, the prosecutor has to come down, all this and that. Then they said, you know, if they have to send you to state jail and keep you there for another 3 days, bruv, all the fucking, like, worst case scenarios started playing in my head. I'm like, bruv, I could actually be in here for time. I started to panic a bit, yeah? Anyway.
Serious?
Yeah, bruv. It's an airport. Like, yeah. They could just say terrorism and keep me in there for fucking 5 months to do checks or whatever. I don't know. I got shook. They're powerless.
Of course.
Like, they beat me up, whatever, but
they beat anyway, you up. That shows everything.
Listen. I said, look.
All right, Trim.
I need one. I said, get me my lawyer. Bruv, straight away, he started panicking. He was like, well, lawyer, well, why do you need a lawyer? I said, bro, you're talking about strip search. I don't speak a lick of Dutch. You lot don't speak English properly. I need my lawyer here. And he's like, lawyer? They're trying to scare me. He goes, you know, if you want lawyer, you'll be here more hours. I said, brother, if I'm here for days, it doesn't bother me. Get me my lawyer. Bro, they're panicking. So who started coming to my door? The brother that I took the photo of. He started coming to my cell, trying to sweet talk me.
Say what?
You know you got a fucking buzzer in the cell. Yeah. I must have buzzed it about 8 or 9 times, bruv. Yeah. Buzzed it, can I get water? Buzzed it, can I get water? I was just pissed. I asked for ibuprofen. Why? Bruv, I was just fucking bare stuff. Anyway.
That's lit.
Then he started bringing me the water, the guy that I took a photo of. And he's like, everything okay? Everything okay? You're a fed. You're not asking me that. You just battered me. Of course everything's not okay. But bruv, like, I just saw this kind of sense of panic. Bruv, this is the thing as well. There must have been like just 5 police officers when I was first in the cell just towering over me. Talking in Dutch, laughing at me and all this and that. That's a bit embarrassing, bro, but I don't give a shit. Anyway, so then their chief constable came after the whole thing. And yeah, she was like, please come with me to the room. Bruv, the minute I come out of my cell, they give my shoes and my bag. I was like, calm, I'm leaving, no problem. So it's the chief constable, me, and there's an interpreter on the phone, yeah? So we're gonna let you go. And I started smiling. I looked at her, I said, why do you think that makes me happy? Like, I shouldn't even be in here in the first place. Yeah, of course, bruv, I was so straight. I said, please tell me why I'm in here in the first place. She goes, well, it's because you didn't give any identification to my officers. I said, what? I said, we just went through passport control. What do you mean I didn't give any identification? I said, furthermore, your officer didn't even ask me for ID. They're fabricating this story to try and justify what they've done. I said, but listen, let's say that was the case. Let's say I didn't give my ID. Would you still do this? Would you still beat someone up and throw them on the floor with 10 men kicking them in? I said, is that the protocol here? And then she just got a bit embarrassed. She was like, no, you know, it got out of hand, it got out of hand. I said, look, no one asked me for no ID. The reason I'm in here is because I took a photo of one of your officers, yeah? So now she said, so she goes, Thing. She goes, yeah, I was
really
gonna come
nice story.
It's an amazing story, fam. It's probably the most intelligent you'll ever hear me, blood.
She goes, serious?
She goes, Thing. She's like, yeah, so I was gonna come onto this. Why did you take a photo of my officers? Will you delete it? I said, nah, I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm not gonna delete this picture. It's not in my interest to delete it. But can you tell me if it's illegal or not to take a photo of your officers, yeah? She goes, 100% not. In her words, she goes, 100% not. I said, then what's all this palaver? Why have you brought it up? Why am I even in here? If it's not illegal to take a photo of an officer, what's the problem? Why are you asking me to delete it? She goes, oh, you know, we're just fearing for his safety. I said, his safety? Look at me, blood. I've just been beaten the shit out of, and you're worried about his safety. I said, listen, his job is to stand in front of hundreds of thousands of people every month checking their passports. His job is, like, he faces the public daily. If he's worried that someone's taken a photo of him, this is not the job for him. He's a public servant. If there's an officer standing there, I can go up to him, take a picture of him and walk off. It's not illegal. I said, let me be real with you. Forget all the police and all the interpreter on the phone. I said, let me just speak to you person to person. I said, I took a photo of your officer. I'll go on it now. It doesn't even have his face on it. I took the picture of the back of his uniform. What is really a problem now is he's just beat the shit out of me. And on 20 different phones outside, there's videos of him doing that. So I said, I can delete this picture. I'll delete it. But what are you gonna do about them videos? And in my mind, I was thinking, Alhan, just shut up. You're making the matter worse. Just shut the fuck up.
You're not though, you're being
mad. Of course
I'm
not. I was being mad real. I said, because of the way he behaved about this picture, there's now videos of him beating me up. What are you gonna do about them videos, I said? I said, they can go on Facebook, they could go on Twitter, they could go on Instagram. I said, what if that shit reaches the news? That shit is police brutality right there.
What's
and you're worried about this picture?
What'd she say?
Bruv, she just looked at the floor. When I told her
why
that
why are you so mature?
Bruv, I'm not an idiot,
you're not
man.
My fridge,
but this is the thing, like, cool, innit? I took a battery in. I could have been that guy that said, sorry, officer, let me delete the picture, sorry, officer. But I'm not that guy, bruv.
If you were black, you would do.
Bruv, you can't talk to me like that, bro. I've come to your country to spend real money. That doesn't scare
me. It's not
me,
his bro. Country, though.
Huh?
It's not his country.
Bro, he was Moroccan. He's not even Dutch like that.
North Africans are crazy as fuck.
Listen, yeah? So that man
my
said,
brother, my kids from North Africa.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, he's not being
crazy
racist.
Crazy as fuck. My kids are North African.
I'm African. So she goes, where can we find these videos of him beating you up? I said, I can't lie. I said, I don't know. They could go online. What are you going to do? Like, what's really going to happen? And you're still worried about this photo. Not once did she apologize, because if a police officer says sorry, that's them accepting defeat. And if this
ego
go to court and what, ego as well, but like legally, if she was to apologize, that shows that they've done the wrongdoing, which she's trying to say that they haven't. So she's like, yeah.
They
so
haven't done anything wrong.
No, she's trying to justify the actions that her officers like took. So she goes, all right, well, we're going to draw a line.
But they wear orange.
Huh?
Their football kit's orange.
They're done out here, bruv. They're
the
done
future's
out here.
Meant to be bright. It's orange.
Their airport's called Schiphol. It's a shithole, bruv. Not Schiphol. Shithole.
In Amsterdam.
In Amsterdam. Yeah, so then, yeah, it's finished. She goes, all right, we're going to draw a line under it. Can you assure me that you're going to do the same? But she's shitting herself. I think her name was Angelina or something. I said, look, I'm not going to lie to
she
you.
She says her name of Angelina Jolie, who's so buff and played Tomb Raider, Lara Croft. And this is how she's behaving.
Horrible. I said, look, I can't promise nothing. Yeah. I might take this further, whatever. And she's like, no, but for us, it's done. For us, it's done. I said, for you, it's done. For me, it's just getting started. I'm 19 years old. Never in my life have I been in a fight. This is the first fight I've been in, and it's all your officers. I said, how does that make you feel? Damn. My whole body was a write-off.
Proper pain.
I had a bath. That's the first time I've had a bath. I just have a shower. I sat in the bath.
Oh, man. I've been there, man.
So I left the room now and I went to get my belongings from the plastic bag. I gave him my jacket. I said, bro, with respect, please put everything back in my pockets. However they came out, whatever, just put everything back in my pocket, made them open my wallet, counted my cash. I said, cool. Then I reached my arm out. I said, bro, please, just put my bracelets on like that. Brother, the same way that they beat me up in that room and treated me like a bitch, yeah? I've done the same, bro. I said, cool. I said, can you put my bracelets on, please? And his boss was stood right there. How can a Dutch Fed put my bracelets back on? Because you were quick to take them off, bro. You're quick to take them off.
So you love?
Yeah.
I said, you bro, might be one of the littest human beings to have ever lived, bro, you know. You're up there with like Jesus, if he's real. You're just up there with Alhan.
Thank you.
My, and Ian Wright.
But, no, stop. End of story's not finished yet, man.
Did you cry?
No, didn't cry. Because the thing is, no. Oh, my mother's life, I didn't cry. Mother's life.
I would have. I
just started shouting rape. I've got brethren that will just fight back, but they'll only make the matter worse. All I had to do was firm the beating for a good 15 minutes. Calm.
15 minutes?
10 minutes. No, yeah.
Oh my. Bro, I've had a fight for 37 seconds and that shit was tiring.
Bro,
fuck.
I'm telling you, when I was on the.
15. Are you sure 15 minutes?
10 minutes.
Bro. But it was 10 getting minutes. Rushed for 10 minutes. Yeah. I don't even know how the police had that much. Bro, do you know how long that is?
It. Bro, I firmed it, fam.
That's a game on FIFA.
Yeah.
10 minutes into EastEnders, so you got 20 minutes left. This is like. My toast is definitely done. My kettle's been heated up. Like, this
you finished
is
your toast. You've ate the
I
toast.
Finished my toast.
Yeah.
I'm no longer hungry.
Time. 10 minutes is a long time.
A hell of a long time to get beaten up.
Bro.
And I not one bruise. Is,
no, there were bruises, fam. My eye was cut. It, bro, I'm...
You look good now, though.
It's been like...
My brother.
A week and a half. That's ask mad. Anyone there, I did not back down once, fam. Man tried shouting at me. I said, who's on what, bro? Who's on what? And fair enough, they showed me who's on what, innit?
They really did.
Quite a few of them were on a lot of stuff. I laid there in it. I was like, you know what? It's actually not that bad.
Was it therapeutic after a while? I feel like 7 minutes into getting beaten up, you just sort of
Shall
lay there.
Shall I be honest
with
you though? Shall I be honest with you? There was one point when I got genuinely shook. When I was on the floor, face down with my legs behind me, yeah? But I was struggling to breathe and man was stood on top of me. I actually thought I was going to die. Like genuinely thought I was going to die.
And then when you don't die, you can just hear like Stranger in Moscow by Michael Jackson. How does it feel? How does it feel?
But shall I tell you something as well? I kind of like the police until then, man, but for now, fuck the feds, fam.